I'm joined now by Ynon Kreiz, the CEO and chairman of Mattel. In your first interview since you became CEO of this company back in April, thanks so much for talking to us today.
It's great to be here, Julia.
So, Ynon, your background is entirely in the entertainment business, all sorts of different types of entertainment, TV, digital media. How do you plan to change this consumer products company?
Well, this story is so exciting because Mattel is the owner of one of the strongest catalogs of children's and family entertainment franchises in the world. Think Barbie, Hot Wheels, American Girl, Fisher-Price, Masters of the Universe, Thomas the Tank Engine, and many, many more ageless, timeless, generational, iconic brands. We have two opportunities. One is to restore Mattel back into being a high-performing toy company, as the second is to capture value from our intellectual property by extending our brands to highly accretive business areas such as film, television, live events, video game, consumer product, and merchandise.
So you recently launched a movie division. Now, Lego and Hasbro both have really had some success launching their brands into the movie divisions, which many say has then gone back and driven more sales. Do you think you're too late in launching a movie division?
We're at the very beginning. Mattel, given the strength of the catalog that we own, there's so many opportunities, there's so much potential. You just have to watch the space and see what is coming.
Shares of Mattel plummeted back when Toys R Us announced that it was going to be shutting down its business. Now, Toys R Us is trying to get back up and running again. What does this mean for you and your business, especially as we head into the holiday season?
Well, the Toys R Us situation is unique to the Toys R Us situation. The industry is actually growing. We're seeing increasing demand, and the other retailers are moving in to cater for this demand with providing great experiences and great toys.
But investors certainly seem concerned that this would be one retail avenue that would be cut off and that could damage your business, at least based on the stock performance. Are you more optimistic now that it seems like Toys R Us is coming back, or have you tried to diversify away from reliance on them?
Well, Toys R Us will have a short-term impact on the industry. We are focused on our future and putting the company on the right trajectory for long-term growth.
So when you talk about all these different things that you're investing in, video games, et cetera, does that mean that you think that those are going to end up being more important than your actual physical toys that you're selling?
No, the toy category is still very important and growing and a great business to be in. So we're very happy with what we are, and we're seeing tremendous opportunity to continue to grow that part of the company. In addition to that, we're seeing more opportunities to extend our brands to additional highly accretive business verticals.
So speaking of the physical toys, though, I know most of them are produced in Asia and many of them in China. What do all these fears about a trade war and tariffs mean for your business?
We are watching the situation very closely, and there could be an impact on the industry. This is outside of our control, but our role is to design an organization that is flexible and adaptive and can respond to market changes and negative headwinds.
And so what does that mean, bringing production to the United States? Is that even feasible from a pricing standpoint?
We're looking at different options, different possibilities, as we're evaluating our manufacturing footprint, and there will be more developments in the coming months.
So when you look ahead to the holiday shopping season and we see the rise of video games and categories that you're not in right now, what do you see as the biggest threat to your business? Is it pricing pressures from a trade war, or is it a competition from other game makers?
You know, our role is to design and create innovative product and experiences that inspire, entertain, and develop kids through play. In this day and age, big brands, quality content, quality toys matter more than ever. And this is exactly what we bring to the table, with the ability to leverage and grow and expand our business in the toy category, as well as additional areas.
And so what do you think is going to be the big trend this holiday season?
We have a lot of ideas, a lot of toys in the marketplace, and we're very excited about a number of initiatives. We'll have to see how it plays out.